back in the house of God one more time. Amen. 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 I thank God for being home. Amen. Amen. In the Lord today, amen, than I did yesterday. I praise God. It took me God knows when to get home yesterday, amen. I didn't get home till about 12:30 something, or about something one, amen. Like the enemy kept trying to keep me from getting to Kansas City, amen. I'm a little sleepy, but I'm all right, amen. I said, Lord, I thank you for what you got in plan for me, amen. I thank you this morning, and I love it for what he's doing, amen. I'm telling you, I had a time missed for flight, amen. My suitcase got to Kansas City, and I'm still in Birmingham, amen. Then got finally got to Chicago, amen. Then the plane got to cutting up. The pilots and the stewards didn't get there. That was another hour, amen. I spent all day in the airport yesterday, amen. Then when he got on the plane, then the pilot seat wasn't sitting right, so they had to fix that. So when I did get home, it was late, amen. And we had a bunch of teenage children on the bus, on the plane too. All of that will pile up at one time, amen. And I just thank God this morning, amen. I told Prophet Reed and Lena, I said, what's going on in Kansas City at the end of that won't be to get here, amen. But I thank God I got here, amen. And I praised him this morning, amen. And I feel good in the Lord this morning, amen, than I did yesterday. That the plan of God is far more greater than what I think, amen. And I'm looking beyond what I see and see Jesus, amen. Great is he that is in me that is in the world, amen. The kingdom of God has risen in me, amen. And it's growing, amen. And I thank God, amen, today, amen. By Jesus, when Jesus was talking to the disciples, he began to tell them things. Amen. And some said it was a hard thing for them. Amen. And some left. Amen. And I thank God for the leaving. Amen. And I praise him today. I thank God, amen, for last Sunday. And when my man of God, the pastor, was talking about Goliath, how David fought Goliath and how Goliath's head, amen, he took the head. Goliath is dead, amen. And he took the head of Goliath. And that's where I took the head of Goliath, amen. And I thank God for the increase of the anointing. I'm glad to be back home, amen. Amen. To see those that are here today, amen. Because truly, I learned one thing. People got to want God.
Amen.
And you got to want God in a way that you would see yourself reaching out to God. Amen. Amen. I can lead you to the water, but I can't make you drink it. Amen. And some people drinking the wrong bitter way, drinking it bitter. Amen. Amen. And I thank God this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. I thank God for the faithful few. Amen. God does a great thing in matter of time, season, and the way he wanted to do it. And I thank God for this morning. Lord, I stay faithful. Amen. I stay faithful. Amen. So this morning, amen, I want to turn to Romans 12:1-2. I'm presenting the church of God as a sacrifice. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Praise God. Because people don't really realize life is very short. Amen. And days are short. Amen. And hallelujah, before you get up in the morning, it's time to go back to work the next day or whatever you're trying to do. Amen. And that's why you need to find yourself faithful while you have an opportunity to be faithful. Amen. And I praise God. Amen this morning. And that's why I say, I beseech you, therefore. He said, brother, but I said, life abundant ministry. By the mercy of God, that, hallelujah, that ye present your body as a living sacrifice, holy, accepted unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what that is good and accepted in the perfect will of God. And that's what I want, the perfect will of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I want the perfect will of God for this house. I want the perfect will of God for the people of this house. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I thank God for the perfect will of God in this house. Amen. God's glory is in this house. That's his hallelujah. And I thank God for that. Amen. And hallelujah. You got to be hungry and thirsty to know he in the house. Amen. You come in the house and you don't expect that, you ain't gonna get nothing. But I thank God today, amen, that I know he is in this house. Amen. I refuse, hallelujah, to deny him in this house. Amen. I ain't looking, hallelujah. I just heard him say, I'm sitting up this house. And I thank God that I'm sitting up in this house. Amen. Woo, glory. He said, sometimes you have to clean house to get a house.
Amen.
Amen. I thank God for the cleaning of this house. Amen. Amen. Oh, Father, I thank you this morning for what you're doing for this house. I thank you, Lord God, for the cleansing of this house. Father, I thank you for the delivering. I thank you for the increase in this house. God, because you said I could call those saved, be not those that were. And Father, I thank you for the roots are coming up. Hallelujah. They are growing, Lord God, leaps and bounds in you. And I thank you, Lord God, for what you say. You add to the church search to be saved. And I thank you this morning for those that in this house shall be saved. Those that come in are saved, designed to do your will, want to walk according to your will. Lord God, I thank you for the obedience of those that you are calling your sheep in this house. And God, I thank you for the glory of you, that you are God and you change it not. And Lord God, I give you glory, I give you praise, I give you honor, because you are worthy of every praise. And Father, we thank you this morning for you just being God. And Lord God, let your word come forth. God, that they have an ear to hear what the Spirit has to say. Oh, God, I keep hearing you say you're adding. And I thank you for the adding. Lord God, I thank you. Oh, God, yes, you have subtract. Now you going to add. And I thank you for the adding. And God, I give you praise. I give you glory for it being done now. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. Thank God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Put on my song, amen, that I love every month, because I love people. Amen. Sometimes people take me the wrong way how I am, but that's what God made me.
Amen.
And I thank God for how he made me. Amen. I love with unconditional love. Amen. But I'll tell you one thing, God told me one thing, I ain't got to let nobody run over me. It's that love. Thank God for the love.
Amen.
Woo!
Right.
I thought about last Sunday, you know, Louise always saying scripture, but last Sunday, that woman, that girl sung that song last Sunday, I'm telling you too, it blow my mind, amen. I mean, God came in last Sunday with her saying, I mean, she put everybody, I said, girl, you sung that song like I never heard you sing before. Amen. I'm telling you, the power of God fell so in that song. She added, like God added more to her in that song. And that girl got to stepping out good. I was like, glory to God. It was just a marvelous time with last Sunday with her saying, I said, girl, you sung that song. And this morning, I feel the same victory.
Amen.
I feel that. Hallelujah. Because when you're trying to keep me from coming into the city, amen, I got my deliverance here this morning. But this morning, I got my deeper depth and my higher heights this morning. I got the glory that God wants me to have this morning.
Thank you, Lord.
I get out of that because I ask myself, what's going on in Kansas City? I can't get here. But I know now this morning, he was trying to keep me from getting what God had for me.
Amen.
Through seeking him. Amen. And y'all, we got the victory. Hear me? We're aware. We got the victory. You hear me?
Amen.
I'm telling you how he showed me in the word. I'm going to show you this morning.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. How God is showing by life.
Thank you.
We are hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Life
Thank you.
More abundant. We got that.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. The enemy don't want you to know what you got.
Thank you, Lord.
You already got it. It's just you receiving and acting on and walking and recover yourself out of the world and see yourself as he sees you. Hallelujah. Oh my God, I got a good life, y'all.
Amen.
I got a good life. See, you need to thank yourself. I got a good life. You got a good life. Amen. Because Jesus said a good stuff. It just us don't see it because we seen it out of the wrong eye. But when we see it out of the eyes where he see it, girl, you got a good life. Amen. That's hallelujah. We robbing our own selves, and we playing other folks. We robbing because it's where we seeing things.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You got to look beyond what you see and see beyond that because it already fixed on the other side. That's just a delusion.
All right.
The enemy putting in front of us. Of the world, so our mindset got to change. You got a victory. You heard me? You got a victory on the inside of you, greater than hell. Great is he that is in you, that is in the world. You got a victory.
Thank you.
It ain't you, it's him that.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
That doing the work. Amen. And I thank God this morning. I got victory. I don't care what it looked like, seemed like, what it done. I got it.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And I'm telling Goliath is dead.
Amen.
He is dead.
Thank you, Jesus.
He's dead.
Thank you, Lord.
I saw something. He said, hallelujah, last time, how Goliath walked 40 days in front of the David's near. 40 days talking his smack. And David came up and said, out of them 40 days, you're going to eat your own word.
Amen.
Come on now.
Thank you.
You just stay steadfast and I'm moving. And he said he'll make you eat his own word.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Ain't you ready for him to eat his own word?
Yeah.
Right now. See, you better have a right now spirit.
Right, Jesus.
Hallelujah. He eating his own word with me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Come on.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
He eating his own word.
Yeah.
Oh, well, he going to take me down because I laid it down. I ain't eating jack now.
Amen.
And I ain't taking nothing off of that.
Amen.
Hey, in the name of Jesus, you got the victory. Amen. 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 You got the victory. You got to tell your own self. Don't look good at nobody else. You got to convince you.
You got the victory.
I'm going to run with it. If I had to tote it, I'm going to tote it. I'm going to run. Whatever way I got to go with it, I'm going to go with it. Now he couldn't take that. That wasn't him.
All right. Thank you. Hallelujah. The slaves are for him. Amen. See, you have to fit what you can use. Amen.
Thank you.
And in the midst of that, I want y'all to see something. Nobody ever paid no attention. Now, he couldn't. He told me, I can't wear all that. He said it was too heavy for me. But when he took off Goliath's head, now that sword was heavy. But he took, God gave him the anointing power to take up the sword of the enemy and cut his head.
Oh, come on.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh. God knows when to give you the power.
Yes.
Thank you. A little boy can pick up a heavy sword and cut the man's head off.
Amen. Jesus.
Don't you know God know when to give you the power?
Yes.
Know how to do what you need to do.
Yes.
Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. When you need to pick up Goliath's sword, don't you know God can
hear you?
Hallelujah.
Speak this.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
And you can cut your enemy head off.
Thank you, Lord.
Because you got my spiritual strength. Goliath's sword doesn't attack you that was heavy that you thought you could handle.
Yeah.
Come on, y'all. Come on, let me get it.
Oh,
I'm telling you.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah, the power of God.
Hallelujah.
Is your strength.
Yes, amen.
Thank
you.
Amen. Thank you. I thank God thank for the Lord. Strength of God's glory this morning.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
amen.
God.
He ain't slack on it. All you got to do is receive it.
Amen.
Believe it.
Thank
and act on it.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. I thank God for it this morning. Amen.
Thank you.
What God is doing
thank
for
you.
Each and every one of us. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
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 Amen. You may not think he's doing anything, but he is.
Yes,
amen.
He is. Thank you, Lord.
He's moving when you don't think he's moving.
Yes, he is.
Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I brought thank my you. Basketball this morning.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. I went downstairs to get a dress and it's going to match the message
amen.
That I got this morning. He said, get your ball. Uh-huh. I was going up the stairs and he tucked my head back to woo. Get it.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
My topic is the way of life.
Right.
The way of life.
Mm.
And this is the world. The ball represents the world.
All right.
And what the world do, it do never bounce you around.
Amen. Oh, amen.
This is the world.
Come on.
The world is bounce you all type of way. This is the world.
Mm-hmm.
And this is and this and we fall in the way of life of the world.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, y'all. That's why we is not as victorious because we the world bounces up. We go this way, wherever way it kids.
Mm-hmm.
I hope y'all getting them.
Yes. Yes.
And that's where God's going to show us in the word what he's talking about. Amen. The way of life. Sometimes our ways are not God's ways.
Amen.
Yes.
And the enemy through us what? He blinded us and brain. Deception. Deception is running rapid.
Yes.
It's running rapid. So not only in the world, but it's really running rapid in the church.
Amen.
Amen. To the place that their people thinking that they got hold of the word, but they don't have it.
Yes.
And so what the enemy do, form of God, but deny the power. You know what I mean? So God is wanting us to get our mind out of the world and let him show you in the word how to get your mind in the spirit. So you will be not led by the world way, but you be led by the spirit.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Way of life.
Amen.
You want some happiness, don't you?
Yes.
Amen.
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 And you one thing about it, you can have happiness right here in this world.
Amen.
These evil days, you can have happiness, but you got to follow it his way.
Yes.
We can't follow it the world way.
Amen.
Because the world way is up and down. Amen. That's what it is.
Amen.
Like this. Up and down. You up today, you're down tomorrow.
Amen.
You go sideways. You go this way.
Yes.
You go out that way. You go behind, you know.
Yes. Yes.
And this is what God said. I'm going to show you today what the world of the evil of the world is doing to us so we can turn our life around our thinking.
Yes.
To life. He said, I come to give you life and life more abundant.
Yes.
Amen. And you have the abundant life. But we so busy focused opposite instead of looking to him. Amen.
Yes.
So I'm going to show you in the word. Amen. So this is why I brought the ball to show you. Represent the world. How it bounces us around. Come on. They bouncing us.
Yes, yes, yes.
Bouncing us every day.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Someday I'm happy. Someday I ain't.
Amen.
But today, we're going to stay focused on what he says. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to show you the word. Amen. I brought the ball to show you. Amen. Let's go to Proverbs. Proverbs 15. We're going to start at verse 18. 24, but 24 is the main verse. The way of life. I caught this, praise God, I'm telling you the truth.
Proverbs
15. 15, verse, I'm gonna start at verse 18. Oh my God. I'm tired of bouncing.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm ready for some showing up ability.
Yes, sir.
He said he came to give me life, and the life more abundantly, so I'm going to get connect with this. Amen. The kingdom within have to grow.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. So I got to stop bouncing, letting the world bounce me.
Amen.
Every time it bounces me, Jesus can't put another brick up there of his glory. Showing me where I'm at, because I'm still looking at that, how you bouncing me. Amen. Amen. Let's start at verse 18. Look what it said. Now this is bothering the mankind.
A wrathful man stirred up strife.
A wrathful man what?
Stirred up strife.
Stirred up strife. Keep something stirred up.
Amen.
Saints, keep stuff stirred up because what they do. Tell the world bouncing.
Yeah.
It stirs them up. All right, look what it says.
But he that is slow to anger appeaseth strife.
See, if you slow from anger, you can't stir up nothing.
Amen.
So I need to keep my cool.
Amen.
When the enemy, when I missed the plane yesterday, I was running down through that. My shoes and my headlamp. Still missed the plane. In the midst of the play, I left my bracelet. They done changed everything, I didn't know it. And I done got real stirred up. I went to 3B when I spoke to went to 3A. And she said, you didn't have a 3 minute. They held me up. I forgot to get the juice out of my bag. And this woman was talking crazy and looked like my flesh was rising. In the world, see, I was rising. You know, I was really rising.
Amen.
And just before I got at the boiling point, like,
amen.
Yes, ma'am. Now, I'm rising. And just as I got at the boiling point, I said, I'm sorry. Will you forgive me? Thank you. She said, that's my job. I said, okay. I took off. She said, yeah, you got to run that way. I took off. Got to ride down. I didn't see nobody. Well, I went to ride the show down. I went to ride, you know. Oh, lost. Just as I got to the plane to see, I looked at it, wasn't no plane.
Oh,
I was riding, man. I was standing there riding. And the lady was so nice. I stood and looked at her. Long as let me see. Thank God for the Holy Ghost. He didn't let me sit down. My breath was too short. See, the Holy Ghost knows how to keep your mouth shut. I stayed quiet for a minute.
Amen.
And then rise. She was so nice. She said, let me look. Then she turned around and told me, said, I don't think I can get you on this. You might be helped us. So put me on standby.
Jesus.
It was rising again. She looked on the list. Only time they could get me out of there was at 4:15. I can't get four number o'clock. Rise, my tongue.
Rise.
Lord Jesus. I ain't gonna send you to Miami because that book, this one book. Then she said, you gotta be glad you don't have no plane going out of the stands. I said,
oh, Jesus.
So that gave me the opportunity to calm down. And I thank God I could have rolled over. But the Holy Ghost knew I was so tired I couldn't stand it. So I couldn't stir up strife.
Amen.
Is I making sense?
Amen.
Yeah. So saints need to learn how to stir up strife. When something get in place like that, don't get upset. But in the midst of that, I met a preacher.
Amen.
Amen. Me and her sat there and talked. Met another, I met me some friends while I was sitting there half a day.
Amen.
He kept me company. Yes. Amen. So after, don't let stuff stir you up.
Amen.
Amen. Because that's where the enemy wants you to work, keep you stirred up. Amen. So that makes you start bouncing. Amen. All right, the way as it says.
The way of the slowful man is as a hedge of thorns.
So we got, can't be what? Slow, lazy. And what the world does?
Lazy, waiting on somebody.
We lazy. Mm-hmm. We don't do nothing. I give. We don't even do nothing. Even make money. Mm-hmm. We stand and do this. We lazy.
Yes,
sir. We slow. Mm-hmm. Slow in business. Mm-hmm. All the time we getting hurt unless it's something that we want. Mm-hmm. Yeah, amen. Am I making sense?
Amen.
That's the way of life. See, I'm showing you what the world doing there.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
Lord. All right, look what it said.
But the way of the righteous is made plain.
The way of the righteous made what?
Plain.
He made it plain to you.
Yes, Lord.
Come on. Mm-hmm. So if you follow him, he gonna make it plain to you. So it won't kick you out of your garden.
Amen.
You won't be bouncing around.
Amen.
Amen. Because he gonna make it plain to you.
Yes.
A righteous man.
Thank you, Jesus.
See, we get out of our righteousness.
Yes, we do.
The righteousness that ain't in us is in him.
Yes.
Because just like the Jesus told him, it's not I that does the work, it's my Father that does the work. Jesus wanted to do the work. So he gonna make it plain. Just like the Father made it plain to him, he gonna make it plain to us.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. All right, look at what he said.
But the way of the righteous is made plain.
Uh-huh.
A wise son maketh a glad father, but a foolish man despiseth his mother.
So what a foolish man despises his mother. Mm-hmm. A foolish man, I'm going to talk, see, men acting what?
Foolish.
And we are in the world, we act
foolish.
We acting foolish. Come on.
Yes, sir.
So, two ways we act. We act righteous or foolish. All right, come on.
Folly is joy to him that is destitute of wisdom.
So joy brings wisdom.
Amen.
The word of God brings joy to you.
Amen.
Through anything you go through, you can get so mad, upset, but you stay calm enough to read some word. What it does?
Bring
the
joy.
Calm you down.
The wisdom of God. Amen? Okay, the way it said.
But a man of understanding walketh upright.
So he give you what?
Understanding.
So you gonna walk what? Upright. You ain't bouncing.
Amen.
You in control. So you ain't bouncing, so you in control of this thing. I'm in control of this.
Amen.
I ain't bouncing around. I got some understanding of this. So I ain't bouncing. I ain't upset. I ain't going all out of it.
Yes, God.
Because I got the wisdom of God. Okay, mm-hmm. The way it said.
Without counsel, purposes are disappointed.
Mm-hmm.
But in the multitude of counselors, they are established.
So sometimes I need to what? Discuss with somebody that. That got some, I'm gonna put it like this, got some sense in the wisdom of God.
Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Then I can, but I ain't going to anybody. It said right there, if they are appointed. Mm-hmm. Everybody ain't appointed to give you wisdom.
Amen.
Come on now.
Amen. That's true.
Everybody ain't appointed to give you wisdom.
Amen.
Everybody ain't appointed to give you some advice.
Amen.
So we need to ask God who I need to talk to.
Amen.
Don't tell everybody, don't talk to everybody, because some folks have you back, walking back. They got to be punished with counsel of purpose. Oh my God, they got a purpose.
If you got a person that got some wisdom and some good, done been through a whole lot of stuff, let me tell you something.
Amen.
I use her mother tongue as an example.
Amen.
That woman done been through stuff, she can tell you something.
Amen. Yes,
Lord. You might not like what she said, but she can tell you the truth.
Amen.
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 Amen. Okay, look what he said.
A man hath joy by the answers of his mouth.
Okay, now. What comes out your mouth? See, right there, you speaking your own stuff. He said, a man have joy by the answer of his, who mouth?
His mouth.
His mouth. It's your mouth we're talking. So I ain't going to get mad with you if I'm talking negative. Ain't no joy in it. You going to look at me like, you ain't talking. You talking like that nothing is. All right, look.
And a word spoken in due season.
A word what? Spoken in what season?
In due season.
In due season.
How good it is.
And it be what? Good. If a person tell you something in due season, if it's of God, it's gonna come to
pass.
My son-in-law, T, he called me like maybe three weeks before I came home about me praying with him about the job.
Mm-hmm.
And I told him what God said. And this Monday morning, mm-hmm. he got his job. He's going in. He was so excited, I told him, I said, I ain't gonna lie, prophet. He said, I believe you with you. I was picking at him. But he followed what I say,
amen.
And God brought it to pass, and he started the word money, and he coming as a supervisor.
Amen.
In the gift that he put in, God put him right back in the gift. See, God know what he doing. You got a prayer. If you obey what God tell you to do and follow to what you good at, Goliath can't take it from you. He gonna put you right back. A supervisor.
Amen.
See, God don't cut the shop. Nothing but God. He know where to put you. Hallelujah. All I can do is just wait on you.
Amen.
Amen. Look what it is. Now, this is where I'm going to get to. Verse 24.
The way of life is above to the wise.
The way of life above to the wise is up here.
Yes.
Saints supposed to be up here. Your world is up here.
Yes, God. Thank you.
You bringing heaven down here to earth. But if you ain't looking up here, and you looking down here, you acting like world. You ain't in the heavenly. You've been bounced around.
Amen.
Amazing.
Amen.
So I got to keep my... when it is up there, Daddy, you say y'all eating steak today. All right, Daddy, Mom, you eating steak today? I'm eating steaks today.
Amen.
Because I'm in the heavenly places. So I got to keep my eyes this way, not looking at... not looking at the problem, but looking at the problem. So if the problem solver see that is displeasing to him, he going to fix that thing up down here. He said, I prepared the table before you in the presence of your enemy. He wants your enemy around, but I'm going to fix it where the enemy can't even mess with your state.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Daddy.
He can't mess with your finances.
Thank you, Daddy.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
He might try to come to your table and get your Kool-Aid, but I'm going to put 5 gallons there. He can't drink them.
Right. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Come on.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on.
Thank you, Lord.
Here you go. Here you go.
Heaven. Keep your thoughts in heaven because you're wiser. The way of life above to the wise. So you wise. Because you have the word.
Yes.
You acting on the word. You acting on the wisdom of God.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on. That what?
That he may depart from hell beneath.
So I'm gonna depart from hell from beneath.
Thank
I ain't gonna live in hell like other folks said they ain't got.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
So even some folks, I'm living in hell on earth. I ain't living in hell on earth. Come on. I ain't beneath.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on.
Thank you.
I ain't living there, man.
Thank you.
Well, I ain't living in hell. Being I ain't living in hell. Beneath, I ain't down here. I'm up here.
Amen.
Come on, y'all.
Amen.
I'm up here.
Thank you.
So that means if I'm up here, the devil can't give me no hell.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. I ain't going to hell, and I ain't gonna live in hell.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Ain't you tired of living in hell?
Amen.
No, I ain't gonna live it because I know I'm gonna keep my head up.
Yeah. Amen. Look to the hills.
Look to the hills for which coming by hell. Abby Junior had his run his baby mama to the hospital. He had surgery on the ear. And Trish kind of laughed at it. And he was ministering to it. I said, praise God, look at Abby Junior.
Yeah.
And he said, Trish called him. And he said, you disturbed me from witnessing. She said, what are you saying? I told her to look to the hills for which coming. Trisha fell out laughing at it. And she said, well, what is she saying? She ain't cussing y'all. He said, no, she's looking at me, but I